Hello everyone, I am the Mademoiselle and welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be perming my natural 4C hair. So I've been natural for about 3 years now and it's been a wonderful journey, like for real. I'm so excited. I already got the mixture mixed or whatever. I cannot wait to see what my perm hair turns out like. This is gonna be fucking... I'm sorry, excuse my language, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to curse, I'm so excited. I'm just so excited. So, I don't have any gloves, whatever. Ugh, the smell, oh my god, the smell. I remember this, ugh, this brings back freaking memories. You know what's like super funny though, like for real? The fact that this is like really not a perm. Deep conditioner, guys. This is the deep conditioner that I use. For those of you who've been asking, this is Africa Pride's deep conditioner. I am not putting no creamy crack in my head, okay? Ah, I thought I was burning my hair. This is a lot of conditioner. I just wasted all this conditioner on a fucking video. It's okay though. It's only a $4 product. It doesn't cost thousands of dollars. Some of y'all probably figured it out because I ain't had no gloves on. I just figured out that I didn't have no gloves on. Some of y'all probably still fell for it. Let's hop right into the video because goddamn damn. What up everybody? I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel. If you see a little bit of residue in my hair, I'm sorry. This conditioner situation was not trying to make its way out of my hair, so excuse that. Before we start this video, if you do not like cursing, exit right the fuck now. If you're with children, get them out the room now. If you do not like me, I mean honestly, you can stay because the longer you stay, the more money I make. I gotta remember to put some more ads in this video. If you cannot respect my opinion or anybody else's personal opinion down in the comment section below, you gonna get blocked and deleted, okay? I'm tired of these people with this, my opinion, that. I'm sorry, but I'm guy here. This is the Mademoiselle's channel. I can block, I can delete. I could do all types of whatever the hell I want on my channel. You can't tell me that I have to take your opinion and I can't stop you from commenting on my channel. I could do what I want on my channel. Women can chef lie. I'm the boss. What y'all not gonna do is be out here disrespecting me or the mafia down in my comment section below. You're gonna leave my people alone. If you have an opinion, you're going to kindly voice that opinion. You're not gonna call no one no names. You're not gonna call me no names, or you're going straight to hell, okay? If you clicked on this video and you thought I was going to perm my hair, you thought I was going to suppress to the white man, you thought I was going to bow down to the colonizer, you got me fucked up. And I'm sorry, like I'm interchanging between relaxer and perm. Like we all know it's really called relaxer. That's the real term for this. A perm is what white people use to make their hair curly, and a relaxer is usually what black people use to make their hair straight. So I'm sorry, I'm gonna be using it interchangeably in this video. But yeah, I would never ever in my life get another relaxer. That shit is terrible, that shit is dangerous, and I love my beautiful natural 4C hair, okay? I like it in its natural state, okay? I would never in my life. So the reason I'm making this video right now is because I had this revelation, right? I thought that I wanted to chop my hair off and like legit just wear it low. Like I still do want to, like I wanna get a low cut. Like I literally just wanna wear my hair in a low cut, maybe a tiny little fro, but I'm kinda like, I don't know, I'm kinda over my hair. Like I've had it forever, I played with it, I've done almost everything to it. And then I honestly am thinking about being a dreadhead. So I was just looking up some videos or whatever, and somehow, some way, I come across these videos. Perming my hair for the first time in 3 years, perming my natural 4C hair, all types of crazy shit. Wait. I said, como safe? Who are these motherfuckers out here perming their hair? I'm thinking these are regular people. Now, this is the thing. Before I start this video, okay, before I go on in my rant, I'm not talking about regular people who perm their hair. At the end of the day, you can do whatever the hell you want with your hair, with your money, with your life. I'm not talking about these regular people who are perming the hair. I'm talking about the people who sit there and they have a whole platform based on natural hair and how natural hair is so beautiful, and they're sitting here promoting self-love and self-worth and why you shouldn't get a perm. Done went onto a whole scientific rant on their motherfucking channels about their dangers of perm, but they out here putting creamy crack in their heads. Can somebody please explain this bullshit to me? I need to understand. What fucking sense does it make to sit there and preach natural hair, curls on fleek, woke, 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 kunyaula, and now you're trying to wear your hair like Becky? It seems like these motherfuckers these days, one person does one thing, and now all of a sudden everybody wants to follow the goddamn trend. Y'all need to fucking understand, y'all hoes are setting examples. You can't sit there and promote all this bullshit, and now all of a sudden you're putting creamy crack in your head. Now, these people that support you, they followed you for that. Now, what do they do? What, now they gotta go watch somebody else. Now they don't have anyone to look up to. I mean, sure, there's other YouTubers out there who make good natural hair videos, but that's not the point. They subscribe to you for natural hair videos. That's like me switching it up on my channel, making cooking videos, bitch. I'm not gonna sit here and cook Haitian food on my damn channel. Don't make no damn sense. But this is the thing. Like, I feel like these people are legit sitting here just doing this so they could get a shit ton of more views, okay? Because realistically, all of these natural people, if you really think about it, their best videos, and a lot of them, and this goes for everyone, if you literally post a video on YouTube called chopping off my natural hair, becoming natural again, why I chopped off my relaxed hair, my big chop 2018, 2019, 2020, whatever the case may be, if you do that, you're going to get a lot of views. Probably try to prove a point that you can have healthy hair while it's relaxed. And then they're gonna do a big chop again, and then they're gonna make another video titled, I chopped off my relaxed hair, bitch. I feel like, genuinely, a lot of them are just putting perm in their hair so that they could go back to their bullshit, okay? And do the whole cycle all over again, because now it's like, it's new shit. So now they could be like, oh yeah, now I'm trying this go around. Now this made my hair grow so fucking much. Even though I know that hair grows only a quarter of an inch every single month, I'm going to tell you guys that I did some miracle shit, and I'm gonna tell you guys to use this product because I'm getting paid. Honestly, next to the people lying about products comes this perming situation. I personally can't stand it. And y'all probably gonna be like, oh, who the fuck are you?
Oh, nobody cares about your opinion.
But bitch, first of all, you clicked, and second of all, you made me coin, okay? So, definitely, you care. You care. And honestly, if I was up here actually perming my hair, you would care too. Because I'm very sure a lot of you guys clicked on this fucking video expecting me to bow down to the colonizer. It wasn't going to be me, okay? My hair is going to stay like this, and it's nigga naps. Okay, you're gonna see me on here looking crazy sometimes, because that's what natural hair does. Sometimes you have good hair days, sometimes you have bad hair days. It is what it is, but I am not going to sit there and literally risk my hair health, my possible internal health, because there's a lot of bad things that can happen to you from putting relaxers in your hair just to please anyone. I have a lot of videos linked down below, videos, articles, shits that you can read on the dangers of relaxing your hair if you are thinking about relaxing your hair, if you have relaxed your hair. There's this video, it's the very first video at the top of the description box. Guys, this woman did a experiment on what relaxers do to your hair. Y'all should definitely watch that, and it's like an amazing video. She did a very good job. To be completely honest with you, we all know the dangers of putting relaxers on our hair. I personally think these motherfuckers trying to kill us these days. And before, I know there's probably gonna be people like, oh, but Madam CJ Walker formed all of these things for our hair, blah blah blah. Yes, but first of all, bitch, are you Madam CJ Walker? Do you know anything? Probably not. Second of all, Madam CJ Walker did that shit so that people can get jobs. That was the point of people straightening their hair back in the day. For jobs, for better opportunities, not to be discriminated against, not to follow trends. A lot of y'all not doing this shit for the basic good of the world, the basic good of you getting a job, the basic good of doing anything important. Y'all just wanna follow trends. You see natural baby girl 468 wanna fucking perm her hair. Now you wanna perm your hair too. See bad bitch 48258 right here wanna perm your hair. Now you wanna perm your hair too. I wanna do every single thing that everybody does. Stop that shit. Kill that noise. Cut it out. Fegrimas. Y'all doing too much for me. I cannot do. This is ridiculous. What's next? My way. I'll see when y'all some bald-headed bitches. Let me know.
I'm telling you, I feel like these people are purposely fucking their hair up. And I'm one of those people, I'm the strongest advocate for hair is hair. I do so much stupid shit to my hair. I chop my hair all the time. I do all types of crazy shit. I just be like, whatever, hair is hair. It will grow back. But that is my choice, my decision. I always believe that everything that you do is your choice, your decision. But your influence is not always your choice or your decision. Stop letting these motherfuckers influence you into doing stupid ass shit. I feel like they're purposely doing shit just so they could push more stuff. This is how I know, okay? I recently made about 2 videos about the natural hair community. Why in hell? Mind you, I dragged the hell out of the natural hair community about how products are worthless. Why the fuck I get all these emails from these companies trying to sponsor me, trying to get me to sponsor their product and sell it to y'all? I got emails upon emails on companies trying to sponsor me, trying to tell me to market their natural hair care line to you guys. I'm confused. They clearly didn't watch my rats. Clearly, yeah, they don't know that a bitch right here, I stick to basics. I stick to the basics. I don't do that changing around, hopping around bullshit. I leave my hair alone. Maybe if they were trying to advertise wave or something, or maybe some braiding hair, because that's, you know, I fucks with those. But these motherfuckers was trying to advertise me natural hair care products. So how do I know that these people aren't purposely fucking up their hair so that they could use these products to sell to y'all? How do we know that they're purposely not doing fuck shit like this so that they can like legit start all over and push a whole new set of different products? I don't trust this shit. If you've noticed, these people have started to do this around that same time. Just Google it yourself. I don't be dropping no names in any of my videos. I let that shit up to y'all. You know why? Cause y'all smart. Y'all loyal. Y'all know the shit. Y'all not stupid. I don't have to drop names. Y'all clearly see the bullshit that y'all see when y'all sees it. Y'all be in my comment section going away, doing the most, dropping names. That's y'all business. That's y'all prerogative. I didn't say anything about anybody's YouTuber, okay? Anybody's God or anybody's fraud. I didn't say nothing about that. Therefore, if you want to get mad, that's your goddamn business, okay? I'm saying stop being a whitewashed bitch. Stop being a follower ass bitch. Get your life together. Stop being crackhead. Love yourself. Go to therapy, because clearly this is the problem here. All of this is a self-confidence issue. We let the media play in to our heads. We let society fuck with us way too much. We let society sit there and tell us that we need shit that we do not need. Sure, at the end of the day, it is a choice. We are all aware that some people are easily influenced. That's why we have all of these stupid ass people with big ass platforms. Clearly, relaxers cause all types of issues in the long run. Even if you don't see the problem now, you're gonna see the problem later, especially after you use it for a long time. I had a perm when I was younger. Like, I was natural for a good minute. Like, my whole life I was natural. I was taking care of my hair up until I was like 12, 13. And my godmother put a perm in my hair, right? Now, I didn't really want it, but at the same time, it was like one of those things, like, I wanted it, but I didn't want it. Like, I wanted it because I saw all the kids had it. All the kids had they little nice hair, and I was out here fucking wearing rubber bands and barrettes. Like, I didn't want to wear rubber bands and barrettes. I was like, damn, like, I want a perm too. Like, I want to be flipping my shit, like, fuck out of here. Like, I want my hair too. My mother livid. My mother was talking so much shit, okay? Like, she was so mad, she called my godmother up, blacking the fuck out. So fast forward to I was about to go to college. I chopped my hair off literally the day before college started. Like, I had fall offs and I went to the beach and there was mad sand in my hair. At the time I was transitioning. So I was like, you know what? I had to take the fucking fall locks out because it was mad salt in it. So my hair was already a good length and I was already thinking about cutting it off, but I was like, At that time, I was still very insecure about my hair. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to y'all, I was very insecure about my hair because I hadn't seen it in so long, I didn't know how it was gonna turn out. And not only that, I was just like, oh my God, like, bitches don't walk around with afros. People were just starting to get natural hair. It was like that. It was just when it started to become a trend. So I was like, yo, I'm dead ass not trying to walk around with no goddamn afro. Like, this is not what I signed up for. Like, I was really stressed the fuck out, okay? I had to go back to Jersey. I got dropped off at the airport and then I put my hat on. Like, I had a hood on. Remember, I had a green Ocean City hoodie on and I had a black little bomber bubble jacket situation. I had this shit on. I was walking through the airport. Bitch, I was scared as fuck, y'all. I was like, nope. These motherfuckers not gonna catch me looking crazy. Like, I was not playing no games. Like, this shit was so sad. Like, how scared I was of like what my natural hair looked like, because it was so terrible. Like, and the wind blows my hat off, and y'all, stop talking to me, eh? The wind blew my thing off, and I had like this little baby fro. Oh my God, I had this little baby fro, and this white lady came up to me. She was like, oh my God, your hair, it's so beautiful. And I was like, I was like, oh my God, a person's looking at me. She was like, no, your hair is so beautiful. It's so lovely on you. I love it. And I was just like shocked. I was shook. I was like, what? Like, she likes my hair? Like, you know, white people, they so nice. You know, they like everything, okay? They like everything. So I kept walking. I was like, you know what? That gave me a little bit of a, okay, bitch. Kept walking. I was getting fucking compliments throughout the whole airport beat. Everybody was like, oh my God, like, you look so beautiful. I love your hair. I wish I had the confidence like that. Da da da, love your hair, love your hair. But deep down inside, I was like, damn, like, I'm not even confident with this. Like, I feel terrible. Like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? I made an appointment to get my hair done, and it was supposed to be that next day. Woke up the next day, like, you know what? I'm gonna start this natural hair journey. Fuck it. I'm not gonna hide this shit. I'm gonna embrace this shit. I'm gonna go to college with an afro. I'm gonna learn to love myself. Cause at the time, I really didn't. I wasn't really comfortable with myself. I ain't gonna stunt. Like, I wasn't that comfortable with myself. And I was like, you know what? I have to force myself to get over this insecurity. So I thought I was gonna be able to, you know, rock. And, you know, not say anything to my mom. If y'all Haitian, y'all know how that shit goes, okay? Haitian parents don't fuck with that shit. Haitian parents, especially Haitian mothers, don't like that whole going natural shit. Most of them are not gonna take that. They're not gonna take you cutting your hair, shaving your hair, dreadlocking your hair. They're not gonna take that. They're not gonna like that shit. My hair was very, very, like, coarse. Like, my hair was never straight with a relaxer in it. So it was my freaking best friend's mom that came over, and her fucking extra ass, she was like, oh, you know what? And I'm like fuck boy, like, damn, like, you always got to do something. So then my mom was like, oh, Brenda. I'm like, fuck, goddamn. Woo, starts going off. Oh, you look like a boy, you look a hot mess. Why would you do that to your hair? Why the fuck would you do that? Going off, literally sounded like an entire colonizer. So at this point, I'm like, damn, like, I do to myself, like, damn, maybe she's right. But then I was like, nah, this bitch brainwashed. I'ma leave my natural hair the way the fuck it is. So, you know, I was still, at this point, that's when I slowed down the weave thing. Like, I still wear weaves, because clearly I see, like, I still wear weaves, but not as much as I used to. Like, I used to have, like, weave back to back. Now, I'm trying to do more braids. I like braids a lot. So, I'm trying to stick to braids, and I'm trying to, like, maybe do the wig thing more often. But, like, as far as, like, sew-ins and stuff, I probably only do those for, like, real special occasions. Especially, like, my friend had a wedding, so she wanted everybody to look the same, so I had to get a weave. So, like, stuff like that. In the summer, I like to keep my hair legit in braids or something, because it just be all over the place. It's very frizzy. It's annoying. So I do it for that. But even at that, I can't leave anything in my hair for, like, past a month. Everybody who knows me personally knows, like, oh, this bitch got a weave. It's gonna be out next week. Like, I'm one of those. I don't like it. Like, I literally just have moments where I just don't like touching my hair. Like, I don't know. And then I'm like, oh, I miss my hair. And then I take it out. And I'm like, oh, I'm tired of my hair. And then I put something back in. Like, it just happens. It's a love-hate relationship. We all know how it is. But honestly, I had decided, like, before I started college, I was like, you know what, bitch? I'm a fake it till I make it, okay? I'm gonna get this confidence, okay? Listen, I'm gonna take care of my hair. I'm gonna love my hair. I'm gonna love myself the way I am, because if not, there's no way I'm gonna be able to succeed in life. And that's legit what I told myself. For those of y'all out there who legit are thinking about perming your hair, thinking about relaxing your hair, thinking about putting any type of chemical to your hair, don't. One, it's dangerous. Two, it's not worth it. You were born with this hair, okay? Just learn to take care of it. Learn what products work for you. Learn what oils work for you. Learn what shampoo and conditioner works for you. Learn what it is that your hair likes. Study the porosity level of your hair. Study the pH level of your hair. Like, actually do the research. Don't try to hide it, because at the end of the day, what you're gonna be doing is you're just perpetuating the idea that something is wrong with you or something is wrong with your hair. You're gonna be spending all of this money to fix something that doesn't really need to be fixed. All you need to do is come to terms with it. And for you fucking YouTube beauty guru, natural, whatever the fuck you wanna call yourself, have a big ass platform based on being natural and empowering little girls to love their fucking curls, okay? Empowering little girls to love their hair. But you have the audacity to sit there and text lash your hair, put clips in your hair to make it look like it is yours, and to relax and or perm your hair. I fucking despise you. You're disgusting, and you need to get your life together. Stop sitting out here promoting fake positivity, promoting fake ass self-confidence. It's not cool. It's okay to be vulnerable with your subscribers, okay? We're all human. We all have the same issues, okay? clearly we're not all the same, but we all do typically have the same issues, the same insecurities. Share that shit with your subscribers. Don't sit there and hide it and try to act like you're somewhat of almighty, this, that, and the third, when in actuality, you really don't like who you really are. You're trying to put on a facade that you do. Don't do that shit, okay? Just don't. Your mind not right, you ain't never gonna be right. Honestly, guys, just love yourself. Go on that journey, legit. If you have a perm in your hair right now, I urge you to cut it off. Start that natural journey. If you have natural hair and you're thinking about permanent, don't. Legit, come to terms with it, research it, love it, study it. Go to therapy if you have to. Legit, do everything you can to be the best you that you can be. Do not let other people dictate what you should and should not be doing. Even though a lot of people are probably watching this thinking like, oh, but you're trying to do that. No, I'm trying to instill some common sense into you, okay? It may not be the best way because clearly I'm cursing up a storm, but honestly, all I'm doing is telling you the fucking utmost truth. People are going to sugarcoat shit. I don't sugarcoat shit. I tell shit the way it is. It is what it is. You take it the way you want to. Either you take that shit to fix yourself or you don't. That's my belief. I believe you need to break people down to build them back up. That's just how I do shit, which is why I talk the way I talk, which is why I do my videos the way I do my videos. I'm not about to sit there and try to act all nice and try to sugarcoat shit, because clearly there's millions of videos out there that you could find where they're out here and they talking to you like that. I don't fuck with that shit. I don't like when people lie. I don't like when people sugarcoat. I don't think it does anything. There's no good in anyone sugarcoating anything for you. That's not going to help anything but perpetuate bad behavior in your mind. It's going to create a bad mindset. I don't fuck with that shit, okay? So, what y'all need to do, if you are one of those people that falls behind those lines, get your life right, bro. I'm telling you, it's the best thing. When you finally love yourself and you realize you don't have to do shit, it's life. That's the reason why sometimes I come on camera, I don't give a fuck. That's why I be looking at a mess sometimes. It is what it is. Sometimes it might be hurting my brand. Honestly, like, usually if you wear makeup and you look really nice on camera, you know, you had the, you know, you got the shebang bang popping, you get more views. But to be honest, I don't give a fuck because I know I'm cute no matter what. So it is what it is. Let me know down in the comment section below, like, am I just being a bitch? Have y'all seen this shit too? Do y'all think it's okay for people to be relaxing or perming their hair, text laxing, doing all of that crazy shit? Or do you think, you know, that it is what it is? I don't know. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section below. If you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. If you didn't like it, it's okay. You could give it a big thumbs down. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, follow me on social media, because I be on here saying a lot of announcements and y'all be missing it, okay? So make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.